I'm going to read them and they will be on the screen. And then when kind of everybody's done with their answer, just let me know and we'll move on to the next one. 15 questions. Y'all ready? We should fly through this like 10 minutes.
Is it
pretty bald? Multiple choice.
Who wants to pray before we start? Alright. Bible says count it all joy when you fall into tests. Different kinds of tests. Alright, you ready? Question number one. No talking, please. Oh man, this is a crazy church.
I love it.
Well, this song starts out. We're never going to test anywhere else.
Alright, I think y'all are set too close together. Y'all need to spread out.
Nervous giggles.
Alright, ready? Question number one, man is a physical being that has the ability to think, feel, and choose. Is this statement true? And if not, fix it so that it is. Here's one. Done, just kind of lift your hand up. I'll kind of walk through it. Don't hold it up, just kind of put it up. Man is a physical being that has the ability to think, feel, and choose. Is this statement true? And if not, fix it so that it is. Done. All right. Moving on. Okay. I'm sorry. Just let me know. I'll hold them. Whatever you need to do. There is change and growth in the Christian life. Explain where this growth takes place and how. Make sure you're writing so people can read. You're writing, Julius. We're going to have another one of these on Dominion. Who else we got, right? Everybody good? Explain what it means to manifest the sons of God. do that. Just a rough. Ready? Number 5. How do you see who you are in the Spirit? Is that everybody? Ready to move on? Yes, ma'am. Number 6, before I can really start affecting my life, where do I have to start expressing who I am in the Spirit? Or we could say, before who I am in the Spirit can start affecting my life, where do I have to start expressing who I am in the Spirit? Number 7. What is the most important key to expressing who I am in spirit? What is the most important key to expressing who I am in spirit? Everybody, you looking at your notes?
I'm trying.
Your phone's dying, sure. All right, halfway there. You ready? Question 8. What is the new man mentioned in Ephesians 4 and 24? Look, I wrote a scripture down for you. Ephesians 4 and 24, and that you put on the new man which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. What is the new man mentioned in this verse?
Read it again, please.
What is the new man mentioned in Ephesians 4 and 24? And that you put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Look up at me when you're done. That's kind of how I see it. Everybody ready? All right, holler at me if you're not. Question 9. Briefly describe what it means to put on the new man. That's also in Ephesians chapter 4, but I didn't write the verse down for you. Looking in your Bibles. Get your phone away from me. Briefly describe what it means to put on the new man. 10. Describe where heavenly places is. Describe where heavenly places is. Still preach. Everybody ready? Nah. Holler at me if you're not. Number 11. What is the difference between us as a new creation and Adam as a new creation? Between us as a new creation and Adam as a new creation. Is that everybody? Okay. Good. Number 12. Four more to go. Ready? What do I need to be conscious of when I come before God? What do I need to be conscious of when I come before God? Quietest this church has been with people. Number 13. Ready? Yes. How does Jesus describe those that have been born again in John 3:6? And why is it important to see ourselves this way? And I did not give you the scripture. You're on your own.
Ha ha. Ha.
How does Jesus describe those that have born again in John 3:6? And why is it important to see ourselves this way? For those of you that may need a little help with John 3:6, it's where Jesus was ministering to Nicodemus. That's all I'm giving.
question. I'll read the question from the top.
How does Jesus describe those that have been born again in John 3:6? And why is it important to see ourselves this way? Two more questions. Number 14. What does it mean to be baptized into the death of Jesus? What does it mean to be baptized into the death of Jesus? Is that everybody? All right, last question. Y'all ready? Here we go. Last question.
Yay.
Can you handle it?
I don't think
I have a choice. Come on. In light of Romans 6:6, how do I need to think of myself? Romans 6:6. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. In light of this verse, how do I need to think of myself or perceive myself? In.
I'm sorry.
Good to have a healing service.
I'm already healed. It just has not manifested.
In light of Romans 6:6, how do I need to think of myself or perceive myself? Romans 6:6. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. Anybody else still right? All right, we're ready. Mm-hmm. Turn your papers face down, like over, face down in front of you. Amber, you want to collect them? Amber, you go that way, and Seth's going to go this way. You go that way. Follow Lisa. Follow mom.
Right here.
face down, Seth. Anybody need to go to the restroom before we go over these? Just go ahead.
Ha 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 ha.